So we will discuss about basics of different system. First of all, what is unit system? A system means it is a way of working or doing any job according to the plan or set of rules. Example of college system, army system, all of our systems. In this, embedded system means combination of hardware and software. Writing any software language, then embedded system, any hardware, then developer, their products. This is called embedded system. In this, the basic definition is combination of hardware and software is called embedded system. First, hardware system contains processor, memory, then peripherals. So, the three main parts: processor, memory, and peripherals. First one, processor. The processor is the main part of the embedded system. It is major microprocessor or microcontroller, DSP or VLSI. In this four, first one is microprocessor. Microprocessor means just processing application only. We cannot develop other, we cannot control other devices using microprocessor. Next one, microcontroller. We can both processing and controlling applications. Next one, digital signal processing. This is signal rate applications. Last one is VLSI, that is very large generation. This just a box. We can develop any chip using VLSI technology. So in this four, due to application oriented, is split into three sections. That is microcontroller, class of microcontroller one section, DSP another section, VLSI another section. So in this three, in the embedded system application, we using this one, microprocessor or microcontroller. In this two, we using microcontroller for embedded applications. Because in this microcontroller only we can control and processing applications. So microcontroller, now we are using the basic microcontroller is 8051, then big microcontroller. Now there is microcontroller available, ARM microcontroller, then various microcontroller all are in markets using for embedded applications. Next one, memory. So memory is second main part of hardware section. It is used for store the data for our programming applications. The types of memory is Pro, EPRO, VEPRO, then class memory. First one is programmable readable memory. It is one time use. We cannot erase the program. Next one is erasable programmable readable memory. We can erase the program and reinstall another one using UVLSI. It has many disadvantage. For example, our sunlight gas, UVLSI. Our product is when we go the program is erasable due to loss. Then second or third one is electrically erasable programmable memory. Using our electrical voltage, we can erase the program. Now, last one, class memory. Using class memory, now we are using class memory. This one, fraction of second, we can erase the old one and then reinstall the new one. The next one is peripherals. So, peripherals means all the connecting and the display devices. All the connecting and display devices. Example, our keyboard, monitor, LED, LCD, sound signal, then serial port, parallel port, ADC, DAC, all are peripherals. That is the connecting and the display devices. That is the input devices and the output devices. This is the input device and the using device circuits. That is some device circuits, that is SPI, ISO. These are some devices to we can connect the this input and output devices.
Next one is
software section. In this software section, first one is language. First, choose which language we use for our writing and programming. Now we are using assembly language or C language. Mainly we are using C language, different C language we are using writing the program. Next one is compiler. After finishing the code, using this compiler, we convert this C file into this file. Then, ISV, that is in system program. Using this ISV, we inbuilt the embedded hex code into our hardware. This hex file embedded into our hardware, then only our product is ready. That is software input, that is embedded into our hardware, then develop the product. This is the combination of hardware and software. This is basic of embedded system. So now where is communication? That is serial port communication, parallel port communication, parallel communication. Then the serial port communication means the data is transferred serially, that is bit by bit. Here parallel, that is byte by bit. So byte means 8-bit data. So at a time 8-bit data sending transmission. Okay, thank you for coming. This another one is simplex, half-duplex, then full duplex. So simplex means that is only communication, that is only either transmit or receive. Example is TV system or radio system. We can receive only the receive signal from TV system. We cannot send any signal to the TV system. Next one is half duplex. Both transmit and receive, but not all at the same time. Example, packet type. Next one is full duplex. That is, both transmit and receive the same time. Example of mobile phones. Now, we are all using numerous applications. Full duplex communication, serial port communication, then asynchronous communication. So, next one is wired and wireless communication. So mainly wired and wireless communication. So wired communication example is SBI, I2C, CAN, Ethernet. These are our wired communications. Then wireless communications, RFID, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi. All of you know the wireless communication and wired communications. The data transmit between two devices using wireless. These are the main devices. Now we are using many technologies. These are some wired devices. This is inbuilt in our PC. It is in our PC as bachelor of PC and has 99 meter. This is the RS 232 meter, the same 99 meter in our embedded board. These two ports using RS 232, that is recommended standard 232. That is second pin is transmit, third pin is receive, third pin is receive, second pin transmit. Again, transmit and receive connecting using these two. We can send the data from PC to microcontroller, microcontroller to PC, then PC to PC, microcontroller to microcontroller. So last one is applications. Some of our applications, our home applications. Our first one, our home application is washing machine. Washing machine is that first main application in our home is for embedded system. So, first of all, inside the washing machine. Switch. This is a basic release means when the switch is on, the motor is running. There is the only simple purpose. Now in the washing machine, you can include wash, rinse, spin, then timer, then S, medium, high. Then okay. We include these applications into our washing machine. Okay. The basic motor means the only motor is running. Now, if our brush application, we include this application. That is wash, rinse, spin, timer. How many time, how much time the motor is running? Then take one hour from depends upon the quality, star, medium, high. These are all compressor. This one is a compressor application. Then only is called compressor application. The next one is automotive applications. Automotive applications. This automotive applications means for example, our car. In our car, we open the door and then open the door. When we open the door, the headlight will, the light will on. And again, seatbelt is not on, then the buzzer is on. Automatic brake is connected, then wiper is on. Then when you enter the closed place, the automatic headlight on. Some of the applications include our car. These are all automatic applications using CAN controller area. These are some of the important applications. Next one is smart car means now our price is all ATM card, fast tag, fast tag, all based on this smart car applications. Now, various